Hello friends, IAS is the dream job for millions of youths today. In my opinion, there are three important reasons why one should prefer civil services as one's career. Number one is duty towards the nation. Joining civil services is a magnanimous duty towards the nation. Mahatma Gandhi says that to find yourself, you have to lose yourself in the service of others. Number two is job diversity, that we will be exposed as a civil servant to varieties of departments, for instance, taxation, social policy making, economic policies, welfare of the people, so on and so forth. Number three is personality development. By becoming a civil servant, we would be able to mold our personality in such a way that we will be becoming very positive. We will develop a positive attitude. We will be able to become problem solver rather than looking at only the problem. A civil servant will be more focusing on the solution to the problem. So we will have a sense of self-accomplishment by developing a personality by joining into civil services, for which we'll be extremely happy. To enter into civil services, we'll have to write civil services examination conducted annually by Union Public Service Commission. This civil services examination is consisting of three stages. The first stage is just to filter, because close to 12 lakh people will apply, out of which some 5 lakh people will write this examination, out of which some 13,000 to 14,000 aspirants will be selected. So the first stage is a filtering stage, which is called as prelims examination, preliminary examination. It is an objective type of examination. The test will be on two papers. The paper one is general studies paper and paper two is CSAT paper. CSAT paper, consisting of max and English questions, will be a qualifying paper. So the filtering will be taking place based on this course which we are going to take in the paper one, that is general studies, which is 200 marks paper. The second stage is more of opinion based paper. It will be a descriptive paper. We'll have to write answers in a descriptive form, and the questions will be basically opinion based questions, analytical questions. So it will give more opportunity for an individual to go for creative thinking and articulating his idea in a very effective manner. And this is what the main stage. This main stage is consisting of four papers from general studies, two papers from optional selected, one paper from essay. Apart from these seven papers, we have a compulsory English as well as the regional language paper. And these two papers are qualifying papers. The score which we are getting from these seven papers put together, which we have spoken before, that is four general studies paper, two optional paper, one essay paper, each of the seven paper worth 250 marks, totally 1,750 marks. So this is the total mark for which we'll be evaluated based on our performance in this seven papers worth 1,750 marks. We'll be called for the third stage, called as personality test. In personality test, the questions will be more of personality based questions. It will not be just information which they are testing. They won't test mostly information. They have adequately tested the information base of us in the earlier stages, prelims as well as mains. So the third stage will be personality oriented questions will be asked, and it will be a conversation which we have to have with the five wisest people in the board, and this stage will be worth us 275 marks. So the total mark which we are getting out of the mains 1750 plus interview 275, totally 2025 marks. If we are able to get close to 50% of this 2025, we will be able to even secure topmost ranks in the final selection list. To tackle this examination effectively, to make your preparation easy, to enrich your preparation, Smart Leaders IAS is going to start a fresh batch, which will be giving you effective, rigorous training for all the three stages, right from the scratch prelims till you clear this examination. We have separately prelims GS class, mains GS class, we have separate optional classes, effective essay writing classes, and we also give adequate importance to test the personality of the individual throughout their preparation, right from the prelims till they go to interview and finally clear this examination. Smart Leaders IAS is having an expert team who are expertised in their subject matter. Friends, one important prerequisite to crack this examination is we will have to be motivated to take up this examination, prepare for this examination and clear this examination. For the simple reason, this examination is not a test of just intelligence. This examination is more a test of our perseverance. So we should be motivated. Motivation is like a fire. We have to keep on adding fuel into the fire, otherwise the fire will disappear. The fuel which we add to the fire is self-confidence. This is the most important attribute needed to crack the civil services examination. We should believe in our ability. Self-confidence is the most important prerequisite to crack this examination. Life is a daring adventure, or it is nothing. If we look at the history, who and all are too successful, you have seen, we will see that those who have taken courageous decisions, these people make a very deep imprint in the history. So we have to have the courage to take up the examination. We need to become motivated. We need to possess the burning instinct, the burning desire to crack this examination. If we are ready for this, then definitely civil services is the best choice available in front of us. Thank you.